Moms for Liberty evaluated the Witten Wisdom curriculum. This report is one in a series explaining our findings.
Welcome to first grade. Just look at those sweet faces. So eager, so innocent. So what happens? Feelings happens. It's a first grade book and it's loaded with feelings. Hate, fear, guilt, shame, pain, and more. It all starts with one child calling another stupid.
The thing that struck me was right on the very first page, someone's calling someone stupid. That is about the worst word that kids, you know, when someone calls somebody stupid, it's, you know, I mean, it's huge to kids. And so that's on the very first page. And then a couple pages later, they're talking about somebody hates somebody. That's another thing we say, you don't hate people. We don't use that word. And so there are those, you know, really, those are kind of like equivalent of the F-bomb in kid land. And so you're thinking, here you are saying both of those words within a couple of pages of each other, and then you're spending weeks on this same book. Again, why? It's inappropriate.
Page 8, Tom built a space capsule. Page 9, John knocked it down.
Tom screams, "You knocked down my space capsule!" John says, "I'm sorry." Others chime in with, "You're mean. You're spiteful."
There are more feelings on page 10.
Smoke filled the boy's eyes. He felt sick. He felt faint. He had never felt so afraid.
On page 11, one girl is jealous of another's hair.
"I'd like to choke Alicia. I hate Alicia.
If you look at the teacher's manual, it really sums it up. There's 32 pages in this book, and 22 of those pages have negative emotions. And again, it's emotion. It's social emotional learning.
Page 12, more wall-to-wall emotions.
He feels ashamed. He feels embarrassed. He feels guilty. He feels afraid. He feels humiliated.
Had enough feelings for one day? Too bad. Now we're going to focus on furious and sad. Witten Wisdom's Teacher's Manual, page 113. Students search for words or illustrations of two types of feelings.
And if you examine the teacher's manual exercises, there's actually an exercise that says, explain that the students will focus on one feeling, either furious or sad, even though there are more feelings represented in the book.
The focus is relentlessly negative.
So even if the child wanted to focus on happy or joy or excited or proud, that's not an option. They're only permitted to focus on furious or sad. And then the teacher's manual just goes into heavy detail about the, you know, various examples of fury. And this is fury by other children.
Page 15, more feelings. This time, sadness over the death of a beloved cat named Whiskers.
The pet Whiskers died and she's crying, she's sad. Keep in mind that the teacher's manual directs the children to focus on the death of Whiskers, a beloved pet, for 4 nights. Not the happy page, the death of a pet. I mean, even as an adult, losing a pet is a very hard thing, and now you want children 4 nights in a row to just relive that.
What's more, the 4 nights of homework focuses on reading with emotion. See page 135 of the teacher's manual. Here's the homework handout explaining the assignment. Students are to read these passages from the book. That's the homework for 4 straight days. Students read each passage 3 to 5 times each night, and they are to read it with the appropriate phrasing and pausing. Then each night, an adult initials that the homework was performed properly.
It's reading homework. They're assigning reading homework out of this book, telling them to go home and read this sample every day. Read it with the proper emotion, the teacher's manual says. What is the proper emotion you would read this with? Like, again, this is not acting class. This is not, you know, a psychiatrist's office. This is learning how to read.
A vocabulary lesson also deals with the death of Whiskers. The story is read again. Then students are asked, how is the girl feeling about Whiskers? We know she's sad, but there are shades of meaning for sad, as explained in the teacher's manual. Students then brainstorm a list of words that mean almost the same as sad. The list includes unhappy, miserable, heartbroken, lonely, glum, and gloomy. It's one thing to read a sad story, once. It's quite another to repeatedly focus on it.
And I think that's another thing to really point out is that the amount of time that they spend on each one of these books. I mean, when we think of school, we think that maybe the teacher read us a story after lunch or something, you know, because they're just 32 pages. Most children's books are 32 pages long. And we think of they read a story in class and that was it. But that's not how this program works.
Wit and Wisdom developed 5 lesson plans for feelings. Each lesson is 90 minutes. So first graders are forced to endure 90 minutes of mostly negative feelings day after day for 5 straight days.
You sent your child to school and they learn about fury, sadness, and shame and negative emotions. I submit that that's not what your intention is when you send your child to school.
So it's not teaching kids how to deal with these feelings, it's teaching them how to have them and how to spew them out everywhere, and that's okay. And in my home, that's not okay.
Moms for Liberty says no to this book and the curriculum structured around it. Too much emotion, too negative, and far too much time focused on both.